Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Numeric Entry Control. The Numeric Entry Control is specifically designed to enhance the user experience when entering numeric values. In this video, I will show you how to add Syncfusion .NET MAUI Numeric Entry Control to a .NET MAUI project. I will also demonstrate how to customize the number format to suit your needs, restrict value changes within specified ranges, and manipulate values using up-down buttons. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once the necessary tools are installed, let me launch Visual Studio 2022. And click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the .NET MAUI application. Then, provide the project name and location. Next, I'll proceed to create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me set up the environment for running the application. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. After selecting the emulator, I will run the application and show you the default output. The application compiles a default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, to incorporate the numeric entry control into this application, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI inputs NuGet package. So, I first open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. Here, I search for the Syncfusion MAUI inputs package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. To do this, open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion Core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion Core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it is necessary to register a trial license key. So, I open the app XAML CS file and register a trial license key using the register license method. To find out where to generate a trial license key, click the link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI inputs namespace. Then, initialize the .NET MAUI numeric entry control. When I run the application, the .NET MAUI numeric entry control is displayed on the emulator, occupying the entire screen. Now, you can enter values, it only allows numeric input. To customize the UI, I load the numeric entry control inside a stack layout and set its width to 200. Now, as you can see, the control is displayed at the top of the screen and its width has been adjusted accordingly. Now, let me show you how to edit values in the control. For this demonstration, I will add another control and set appropriate values to both controls. As you can see, the given values are displayed in the default format. You can edit the values when the control has focus, and it will be updated when the control loses focus. Now, let's see how to change the value format. You can format the numeric values by using the custom format property. By default, values are formatted based on the current culture's decimal format. For instance, in this demonstration, I will add another control inside the stack layout. To format values as currency in the first control, set the custom format property to C. To format values as a percentage in the second control, set the custom format property to P. To format values as a decimal in the third control, set the custom format property to N. You will observe that values are formatted based on the given format and displayed as currency, percentage, and decimal values, respectively. If you want to format the decimal and fractional digits of the value, you can use the zero format specifier to set the minimum number of decimal and fractional digits. To illustrate this, I set the appropriate value to the custom format property for all controls. You can observe that the zero placeholder replaces the zero with the corresponding digit present in the value, otherwise, zero appends to the leftmost position of the value. Now, let me show you how to restrict value changes. First, I remove the custom format code changes. By default, the numeric entry control allows empty or null values when the input is cleared. To restrict null values in the first control, set the allowNull property to false. After the control is loaded, if you clear the input value in the first control, you will see that the control returns zero. To restrict the value within a specific range in the numeric entry control, you can set appropriate values to the minimum and maximum properties. Once the control is loaded, if you modify the value and it exceeds the specified range, you will observe that the value adjusts itself depending on whether it is approaching the maximum or minimum value. To prevent the user from editing the numerical value in the editor, simply set the isEditable property to false. By default, this property is set to true, allowing you to edit the numerical values. Notice here, the editing is disabled. Next, let's see how to change values in the numeric entry control using up-down buttons. Even though isEditable is false, you can edit the value using these buttons. To enable this functionality, set the up-down placement mode property to inline. By default, values in the control are changed based on the small change property, and its default value is 1. Notice here, buttons are displayed and the values are updating properly when up-down buttons are used. By default, values in the control are changed based on the small change property. For example, I set the small change property to 5. Looking here, the numeric entry control increments or decrements the value by 5 every time the up-down buttons are used. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add Syncfusion numeric entry control to it. I also showed how to customize the number format to suit your needs, restrict value changes within specified ranges, and manipulate values using up-down buttons. To learn more about numeric entry features, you can check the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.